Hello and welcome to the first content video of OCR A-Level Computer Science Paper 1. We're going to start by looking at processors. This is the first of a fair few videos on this, but let's start by talking about the components of most typical processors. But before we do so, let's just say what a processor is. So a processor is a hardware device that can execute instructions written in software. The word execute is used a lot in this topic. It just means to carry out. And processors are absolutely critical because that's all a computer does, right? A computer just carries out instructions. We tell it the instructions, it does what we say, and the processor is what is really doing all that hard work. Now, the word processor and CPU are used a lot of the time pretty synonymously, and I'm sure I'll slip into it throughout this video and the next few, but really a CPU is a particular type of processor. The CPU in particular, standing for Central Processing Unit, controls the execution of computer programs in the computer. So you might have several processors in a computer, but you have to have a CPU to control the whole system overall. Typically, when you've got an instruction to be executed, the CPU deals with it first. It may delegate it to other processors in your computer. So here's a picture of a CPU. Pretty underwhelming to look at. They're just a single circuit board, normally square. These little pins connect up to the motherboard. In a desktop computer, often it's covered by a fan because these get hot. But there are other processors in a computer. So one we'll look at in a future video is a graphics card, or specifically within it, a GPU, a graphics processing unit, that specializes in visual processing. So the CPU might delegate processing related to graphics to a GPU. There are other processors which are less obvious. Things like a sound card you might have if you're really into music production. If you've got a fancy microphone, it may feed into a sound card which processes it in a higher quality than a typical USB microphone would. And if you listen to the sort of marketing material from phone companies, you can also pick up on the fact there are other processors beyond a CPU. Here's a picture from one of Apple's presentations where it's got a CPU, it's also got a GPU, but it's got two other branded processors. One for AI and one for the biometrics Apple use. They're separate processors specialized for their particular jobs, but the CPU is still there. The CPU is really controlling the overall processing. It will just delegate instructions to different processors. Now, no matter the processor, typically it will have the same three main components, an ALU, a control unit, and a set of registers. So me showing it like it's three units only is a massive oversimplification, of course, but these will be present in processors, whether it's a CPU or GPUs or other processors. So what is the purpose of each of these units? Well, first of all, ALU stands for arithmetic logic unit, sometimes written with a forward slash after the word arithmetic. So the ALU consists of the circuits that perform the operations on the data. An instruction will tell the computer to do something with some data. And typically these are pretty simple. As remarkable as a CPU is, they typically deal with pretty simple instructions, things like adding two numbers together, multiplying two numbers, things like comparing one value to another value. They're typically pretty simple instructions, but we still need to have circuits which actually do those instructions, and the ALU is where most of these operations get completed. However, we always need to have a manager in these situations, and the control unit is really the part of the CPU that manages the whole process. So it consists of multiple circuits which coordinate the activities of the processor. So it will tell the ALU what to do, it will move stuff to and from the registers, and it's got a component within it called a decoder, which will decode instructions, but we'll talk about what that means in a future video. Now, ALUs, control units, are busy circuits, they're always working, they're doing stuff. A register is really passive. I would think of it like a box. It's a box, you can put data in, and it's memory, so it holds the value and remembers it. Now, registers are the fastest memory we have in a computer, and we've got a few different types which we'll cover. They're very, very small. So a register may only be able to hold maybe 64 binary digits in each one. You might have maybe a few hundred registers in a processor, maybe more, maybe less. We're not talking about a huge amount of storage here. They're really, really small individually, and you haven't got that many of them. They're used for holding values which a CPU needs now or will need in the future or has just finished with. We'll dig into some particular registers in a future video. Let's just finish by talking a little bit more about the ALU. which is where a lot of the action happens. It's where it actually carries out most of our instructions. So arithmetic, logic give us the two key components or the two key areas within an ALU. We have circuits which perform maths operations, and we have circuits which perform logical operations. And if you want to use another word, you can use Boolean as opposed to logical. Boolean will always give us either a true or false response, true being the same as binary one and false being the same as binary zero. Now, to give you a couple of examples, and this will make most sense if you are just revising this content, you may not have got this far in the course yet to fully understand this, but maths, we'll be doing things like addition, and there will need to be a circuit in the computer which can perform addition. So the circuit which performs addition is unimaginatively called the adder. So here is a picture of an adder. These little symbols represent an individual circuit which performs some Boolean logic. We don't tend to worry about how these work in computer science. That's a job for electrical engineers. This circuit will add up two binary numbers. So 1 plus 1 in binary is 0, carry 1. And the ALU will have a circuit which can perform binary addition. Now, this picture here just represents adding one digit or adding two digits at a time. So to add up a longer number, I need lots of these all chained together. If I want to subtract, I need its own circuit. If I want to do division, I need its own circuit. So for every operation, there has to be a circuit in the ALU which can do it, which adds complexity the more operations we support. In terms of the logic, to give you an example of a logical operation, if I want to do something like bitwise OR, that's performing the OR operation on two binary numbers, I would need loads of OR gates back to back. I need as many as I've got digits, and that's a bit simpler to do. We feed it two digits and it will give us results which match the OR operation. I've got to have the same set of logic gates for AND, the same set of logic gates for NOT. So for every operation the processor is designed to do, there has to be a circuit in an ALU which actually performs it, which is something to bear in mind for future videos.